His face. Come and fill this place. Come and fill this place. We wait for you to come and show your glory here today. Come, you're there for me. as a deer pants for living water, so pants my soul for you. As a deer runs to find water, I run, I come running to you. I come running, I come running as a deer runs, knowing that I'll find living water for my soul that satisfies. Satisfy, yes, Lord, you satisfy. You satisfy the deepest part of me. Oh, you satisfy my soul. You satisfy the deepest part of me. You satisfy the longings of my heart. So I will run to you. I will run to you. I will run through the forest to get to you.
As a deer goes forth in the wilderness, and it thirsts for you. As a deer goes around, thirsting for the streams of living water, we come to you. No matter what season we're in, how dry we feel, we come to you, we come to you, God. God, we step in the streams of living water. So we dip our feet in that water, and it feels so good. so refreshing. God, we come to you with our burdens. We lay it all down, oh, our heaviness, and God, we thirst for you as a deer pants for the living water. We come to the streams of living water, oh, to drink deep from the wells, to drink deep from the living water. We come to drink from the living water. It's from your water, God. It's from your water we are refreshed. We're reminded of why we do the things we do, why we live for you. God, we ask of you, come rain down your living water, oh God, we pray to you, won't you let it rain down on our souls, your living water, so rain it down. Down, come bring it down, your living water, come bring it down, come bring it down, come bring it down, your living water, come bring it down, come bring it down. Down your living water, come bring it down, come bring it down, come bring it down, your living water, come bring it down, come bring it down, come bring it down. Your name. matter how we feel. God, we invite you to rain it down. Bring down your living water on our souls. Every part of us that thirsts for you. God, we open up our mouths. We open up our hearts. To let it rain it down on us.
foundation. No one can pluck me from your hand. No one can pluck me from this truth. 'Cause I am yours. Oh, I am yours, forever yours. And unshakable, so let my roots go down deep. Unmovable and unshakable in you. Wanna be unmovable and unshakable, so let my roots go down deep. Unmovable and unshakable in you. So let my roots go down deep, unmovable and unshakable in you. I wanna be unmovable and unshakable, so let my roots go down deep, unmovable and unshakable in you.
Bye.
until the end. This will be my song, God. This will be my prayer until the end, till the very end. This will be my song, God. This will be my prayer until the end, until the end. I want to be unmovable and unshakable, so that my roots go down. In you, I want to be unmovable and unshakable, so let my roots go down deep, unmovable and unshakable in you. This will be my song, God. This will be my prayer until the end, until the end. My song, God. This will be my prayer until the end. Till the end. I want to be unmovable and unshakable, so let my roots go down deep. Unmovable and unshakable in you. I want to be unmovable and unshakable, so let my roots go down deep. Unmovable and unshakable in you. I know that as you grow my roots down deeper, this means I grow up higher too, and this means that I will go through growing pains, but I know that it is worth it, and I know that you are worth it. So plant me deeper in you. This is what I long for. Oh, plant me deeper and grow me higher. Oh, glory to glory, bring me, and I will go whatever it takes to remain firmly rooted in you, and not just to stay where I am, but to grow further and further in you. I want to be found growing in you, growing in you. My roots grow down deeper, my branches go up higher, oh, further in you, deeper in you. My roots go down deeper, and my branches go up higher, further in you, oh, further in you. My roots go down deeper, my branches grow up higher, further in you, God, further in you. My roots go down deeper, my branches grow up higher. I want to be found growing in you, oh, growing in you. My just can't have enough. I want more, I want more of you. I just can't have enough. I just can't have enough. I want more, I want more, only more of you. I just can't have enough. I just can't have enough. I want more, I want more, only more of you. I just can't have enough. I just can't have enough. I want more. My soul is cast down, I will command it to praise you, command it to hope in you.
I will tell my soul, bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me shout out.
And every fiber of my being shout out. I will command every fiber of my being to praise you.
Tell my body, tell my soul to shout unto God. Songs of praise, a multitude keeping festival.
Without ceasing, without slowing down, we will shout, we will sing new songs to you.
New songs from our spirit, man. New songs of praise we give to you. Every morning, every day, God, we give you praise.
As you give fresh revelation of your love,
of your goodness, God. Remind us of your faithfulness, and we will sing to you.
Oh, how forgetful we can be, but how gracious you are to remind us of who you are, God.
So God, we say these things I remember. As I pour out my soul to you.
That you have been faithful, you have not abandoned me. You have been faithful, you have not forsaken me.
You have been faithful, you've been so good to me. You have been faithful, you are good, you're so good to me.
Should I have trouble recalling your goodness? Oh come and remind me now of the times you took me from the ashes, brought glory of it.
So God, we ask, why are you cast down, oh my soul, and why are you in turmoil within me? But we say in response, my hope is in the Lord, and I shall again praise him, I shall again give him thanks, give him worship.
Salvation and my God.
Place my hope in my God. I will praise him. I will praise him. My salvation all my days, all my days.
I will hope in the one from whom all blessings flow. Hope in the one from whom comes every good thing.
Cause I know that those who place their hope in you will not be put to shame, not be put to shame.
Instead you lift us up, instead you shake off the dust.
You lift us up on eagle's wings. You take us from the dark places into your light.
You say, my son, my daughter, come up here with me, and I will show you great things.
So God, we seek to listen to you. Not just to hear, but listen to you. We follow the voice of hope, the voice of truth.
We tune in, to your voice. We tune in. To hear you now.
Cause we were made to hear you, God. Oh, we're listening. So we tune into the voice of hope. Voice of hope that's from our God. Oh, we tune into a voice of truth. Truth that does not disappoint.
And we reject every lie that
back to you, give back to you your love. your steadfast love be close to our hearts, be close to our hearts. Oh God, we ask you, fill us with your love, write it upon our hearts, keep it close to our hearts, your love.
So as you call me deeper still, so as you call me deeper still, I will choose to trust, I will choose to trust. When I can't see in front of me, I will choose to trust. Call me out upon the waters, great and old, where feet may fail. And there I find you in the mystery, in oceans deep. My faith will stand. Call me out upon the waters, great unknown, my feet may fail. And there I find you in the mystery. oceans deep, my faith will stand. And I will call upon your name and keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace. For I am yours, and you are mine. The grace abounds in deepest waters, your sovereign hand will be my guide. My feet may fail and fear surrounds me, you never failed and you won't stop now. And I will call life is in the hands of the maker of heaven. I lean not on my own understanding. My life is in the hands of the maker of heaven. And I give it all to you, God, trusting that you'll make something beautiful out of me. I give it all to you, God, trusting that you'll make something beautiful out of me.
Nothing I hold on to. I Yes, God, it is our desire to be a people of one God, people of one lover, a people that can let go of everything else in order to cling to one God. We thank you, God, for what you're doing here in our midst, how you're drawing us ever closer, ever deeper into you. As our hearts cry out for more of you, Lord, would we experience a greater fullness of your presence in every area of our lives. You give us the courage, Lord God, to let go of everything that we need to let go of in order to hold on to you. We thank you, God. We pray these things in your name. Amen. At this time, we'll actually be transitioning into a time of prayer. This morning, we'll be praying for the church in America. This is a very crucial hour for us to be praying on behalf of our church in the nation of America. So as I lead us out in prayer this morning, I'd like you to come into agreement with my prayer and then follow my prayer with your own intercession. Lord, we confess that we need you, that try as we might, we cannot walk this walk without your strength. We cannot accomplish what you've called us to do unless you empower us. We come to you in prayer because we cannot do anything outside of your spirit. We come to you in prayer because we need you. We pray that this would be the hour that the church in America would seek you once again in the place of prayer, that you would meet your church in their prayer closets and corporate prayer meetings, that the spirit of intercession would come upon the American church once again, and you would raise up for yourself a church on our knees, a church that believes in the power of prayer. We pray that you would anoint the prayer movement with your fire, that it would grow in momentum and in urgency, that this would be the hour where your church learns to pray. Let's pray.
church will be called a house of prayer, spirit of intercession.
Rise up with a spirit of intercession at this hour, that we would come to you, Lord God, on our knees,
spirit of
asking, Lord God, for divine intervention, asking for more of you.
The church will be
that this would be the hour of prayer,
a house of prayer.
This would be the hour of prayer,
spirit of intercession.
Would you clothe your church with the spirit
of
intercession?
Will be
is light. Your word is life and truth, living and active, sharper than any double-edged sword. May you raise up your church in America as a church that wields the sword with power and dexterity, that your church would stand firm on your word no matter what temptations may come their way, temptations to compromise the truth of your word, that the church would not be ashamed of the gospel, the full counsel of God. We come against a spirit that mocks your word. We come against the accusing voice of the enemy. We come against the voice of the world that tempts us to backpedal on your word. We declare that the law of the Lord is perfect, reviving the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure, making wise the simple. The precepts of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. The commandments of the Lord is pure, enlightening the eyes. The fear of the Lord is clean, enduring forever. The rules of the Lord are true and righteous altogether, more to be desired that are they are than gold, even much more than fine gold, sweeter also than honey and drippings of the honeycomb. Moreover, by them is your servant warned. In keeping them, there is great reward. May you raise up a church that stands on your word. Let's pray. Lord God, we pray that at this hour, the church in America would be a church that is purified. God, would you call your church back to a wholehearted, uncompromising love and devotion to you? Lord, strip the names of Baal from your church in America, the idols of money, comfort, fame, the American dream, the tyranny of fleshly desires. Would you purify your church? Would you rid her of all her other lovers, that you would lean only on her beloved? We pray that this will be the time when you raise up a church without mixture, that all traces of lukewarm and cultural Christianity would come to nothing, that your church would be washed and purified through the washing of your word, ready for your return. Wean your church from a man-pleasing spirit. May she fear the Lord alone. Rid her of the fear of man and a desire for the accolades of man. May this be the hour that your church rises up in greater purity, in greater wholeheartedness and surrender to you. Let's pray.
Church of pure devotion. Let them be a church that walks in truth. Let them be a church with all hearts wholly devoted to you. Let them be a church of pure devotion. Let them be a church that walks in truth. Let them be a church that walks in righteousness, fully in love with you. Let them be a church of pure devotion. Let them be a church that walks in truth. Let them be a church that walks in righteousness. Oh, let them be a church of your devotion. Let them be a church that walks in truth. Let them be a church that walks in righteousness. Let them be a church of your devotion. Let them be a church that walks in truth. Church that walks in righteousness, fully in love with you. Let them be a church, your devotion. Let them be a church that walks in truth. Let them be a church that walks in righteousness, fully in love with you. No compromise, no mixture. Oh, your church.
Purify your bride.
Oh, you're purifying your bride.
Purify your bride at this hour.
You are jealous for them. You are jealous for them.
You are jealous, God.
Let them be a church, pure devotion. Let them be a church that walks in truth.
Call your church.
Let them be a church of righteousness, fully in love with you. Church, your devotion. Let them be a church that walks in truth. Let them be a church of righteousness, fully in love with you.
God, would you build for yourself a church that is prepared to withstand whatever may come the days to come? A church that is unmovable, unshakable until the very end. A church that will finish the race and keep the faith, that will not forfeit her crown of righteousness. Strengthen her in the day of trouble. Allow her testimony to be one of victory and steadfastness in the face of shakings and testings. May believers count the cost and still count everything as loss compared to knowing you. Release the grace to withstand persecution and prosper your church in the face of opposition. May your church shine brighter than ever against the backdrop of a darkening world. May this be the hour where you raise up a church that is prepared to withstand all circumstances. Let's pray. God, we pray on behalf of the church in America at this hour. Lord God, in the midst of uncertainty, in the midst of so many things escalating and accelerating at this hour, Lord God, where we are so close to a tipping point, Lord God, may this be the hour where you raise up your church. May this be the hour where you raise up a church that is strong, that stands upon your word, a church that prays to you, God, a church that is purified from every other idol, Lord God, and a church that has known favor, that has known prosperity, that has known increase, Lord God. This may be also the hour, Lord God, where you teach your, Lord God, about the fellowship that comes with suffering as well, Lord God. May this be the hour, Lord God, where your church rises up unafraid, emboldened, Lord God, because you're the God who stands with her, Lord God. May we know that as the hour draws closer and as the hour draws darker, Lord God, that this will be the time, Lord God, where your church will rise up in greater glory. Lord God, where she will shine brighter than she has ever before. Lord God, may we see your hand at work in your church in America. May we partner with her, Lord God, in prayers and in worship, Lord God. May we see your work at hand at your church. We thank you, God. We pray for all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Let's take a moment and sing "Nothing I Hold On To" over America, over the church in America. That this would be their cry, that this would be their prayer and their song, that they hold on to nothing, but that they trust fully in the Lord.
Something beautiful out of me. I give it.
God, trusting that you'll make something beautiful out of me.
Yes, God, we give it all to you, Lord. We bring fresh surrender this morning. God, we lay down everything, God, all that we are, Lord, for all of you, God. And yes, we pray the same for America, God. We pray fresh surrender over the church in America, Lord, that they will be a church that is purified with no compromise, fully believing in your word, in every word that you have laid out in the Bible, every word that your Holy Spirit speaks, that they would be attentive, that they would be awake, that they would not shrink back at this time, but that they would rise up in intercession, that they would rise up, and that they would know more and more of who you are and not reject any part of you, but embrace all of who you are, God. We thank you, Lord, that, God, you are a God of ands, Lord, that you are merciful and just, that you are compassionate and righteous, Lord, that you are loving and good and kind, and God, that your ways are perfect in our lives and in the world, God, in the nations. So, Lord, we praise you this morning. We thank you, and we give you all the glory in Jesus' name. Amen. Thanks for joining us this morning. We hope that the Lord spoke to you and encountered you, and that you gained more of a heart for America as we prayed. We invite you to come tomorrow, Thursday night, from 8 to 10 for our Thursday night, our newly established Thursday night watches. So if you haven't heard, there are no longer Tuesday night watches. They have moved to Thursday, and we'll still have Wednesdays as usual. So we'll see you tomorrow or next week. Have a good day.